Hello, my dear students. Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. D.G. Saxena, Professor and Head of the Department of Food Engineering and Technology at Sant Lungowal Institute of Engineering and Technology, Lungowal. I am here to present the paper, Technology of Meat, Poultry, Fish and Seafood Products. The tenderization process is very important process in case of meat. And this aspect in the present module will be explained to you by my co-author, Mrs. Aarti.
Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Khan Nadia from Sant Lungowal Institute of Engineering and Technology on behalf of Ms. Aarti. Today I am going to talk about Module 9 of Paper Number 8, Technology of Meat, Poultry, Fish and Seafood. In this module, we will be learning of meat tenderization. Meat tenderization is breaking down collagens in meat to make it more palatable. The tenderization process begins just after slaughter. There are various ways to tenderize meat. These include natural way. Most meat is normally required to age for a period of up to 3 weeks in order for it to be commercially acceptable for human consumption. Good quality meat can be aged longer if desired. During the aging process, the connective tissues of meat are broken down by natural enzymes of meat, thereby improving the tenderness and edibility. Meat can be dry aged for longer time with weight loss or wet aged for shorter time with no weight loss. Meat is kept refrigerated during aging and the humidity is controlled. Several methods are employed to reduce the aging period and to increase the degree of tenderness. One of these is regulated application of heat, light, or both of these to meat, which speeds up the natural enzyme or bacteria. Now, mechanical tenderization. Mechanical tenderization is a method whereby fine incisions are made in meat by closely spaced, specially designed knives which cut the connective tissue. The mechanical tenderization process takes less than 1 minute with a roller type tenderizer or a crank type hand operated tenderizer. Meat which has been treated in this manner is immediately tenderized without the use of chemicals or other artificial means or the need to wait for natural bacterial action to take place. Meat which has been mechanically tenderized retains more of its natural appearance, shape, color, and weight. In this module, I will be discussing different factors influencing tenderness and different methods of meat tenderization. Factors influencing tenderness include stress, pH, pre-slaughter electrical stunning, aging, age, influence of vitamin D supplementation. Methods of meat tenderization include natural, mechanical, chemical, marinating, and freezing. During tenderization, proteolysis affects all muscle proteins including connective tissue, and it's now well established that postmortem proteolysis of myofibril and myofibril associated proteins is responsible for this process. A number of non-enzymatic aspects also influence the meat tenderization process. such as temperature, pH, and calcium ion concentration. Generally, meat aging is done at low temperatures, and some studies showed that a freeze-thaw refrigeration cycle can prevent a high rate of sarcomere shortening, leading to a more tender meat. Low temperature also decreases the glycolytic process by lowering the enzyme activity, reducing the pH fall. A low pH can cause inhibition of proteolytic enzyme activity, denaturation of myofibril proteins, and excessive shortening, and as a result, lead to toughness and loss of water holding capacity. The sarcoplasmic calcium ion concentration increases finally to 0.2 millimolar during tenderization due to the loss of the ability of sarcoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria to accumulate calcium ions. This concentration is about 2000 times that in resting skeletal muscle. While calcium is necessary for muscle contraction, it is an activator of proteolytic enzymes, and many authors have shown that calcium injection as carbonate enhances the tenderization process. By the time the meat is in the refrigerated display, its tenderness or otherwise is largely set. Obviously, the best cuts are the tenderest, but even meat that should have been tender can become tough by stress just prior to slaughter. In general, breed and sex have relatively little effect on tenderness, but pre-slaughter treatments such as vitamin D injections or medication, coit handling, and good transport conditions on the way to the killing plant, electrical stunning to render the animals unconscious immediately prior to slaughter, freezing, then thawing, and then aging to allow muscle enzymes to break apart muscle fibers, all treatments significantly improve tenderness. The most common factors influencing tenderness are stress, pH, pre-slaughter electrical stunning, aging, age, influence of vitamin D supplementation. Juiciness and tenderness are two very important factors when it comes to meat quality. Both factors are influenced by the cut of meat you choose and how long the meat is cooked. The more a muscle is used, the stronger and therefore tougher the cut of meat will be. And the longer meat is cooked, the more liquid it loses and tougher it becomes. Factors that also influence tenderness and juiciness are the animal's age at slaughter, the amount of fat and collagen contained in particular cuts, and to a small degree, brining. Here we will be briefly discussing these factors which influence the tenderness. Number one is stress. It's prior to slaughter and is one of the most important influences on ultimate meat tenderness. Research in Australia and in New Zealand has shown that when stress in transport, yearning, handling and slaughter was minimized, beef meat was consistently at the tender end of the scale, regardless of breed. Similar results have been shown for deer and for sheep. Now, take a look for influence of pH. High pH meat is darker but less consistently tender than normal pH meat. The pH of living animals is around 7, but after death, the sugars in muscles are converted to lactic acid, lowering the pH. A normal, non-stressed animal has pH of around 5.5 after death. 24 hours after slaughter, all the sugars have been converted. It was found that high pH in venison leg muscles, a muscle not normally affected by elevated pH, indicating stress before slaughter, were much tougher than normal leg muscles even after 6 weeks aging. Influence of pre-slaughter electrical stunning. Where animals are routinely rendered unconscious by electrical stunning immediately prior to slaughter, the muscles are positively affected from the tenderness point of view. Mainly through mechanical fracturing, some of the joint, intermediate and shorter muscle fibers of meat. Cattle varieties breed from the tropical Bills Indicus breeds such as Brahman, Santa, Gertrudis do not seem to as affected with only the joint fiber component fracturing, the immediate and short fibers remaining unaffected. BOS Taurus, the European and English cattle breeds, Angus, Hereford, Carolus, Galloway, Saliers and Shorthorn, etc. are more markedly affected by electrical stimulation. Influence of aging. Varied rapid chilling virtually immediately after slaughter causes the muscle fibers to contract except for those being stretched by the weight of the carcass. For example, tenderloin. These shortened muscle bundles resist shear forces and cause tough meat. The relaxed muscles on the same instantly chilled carcass are elongated and opened out and thus remain relatively tender. The greatest activity is within the first 7 days of aging, and by 14 days the greatest gains in tenderness will have been achieved. Chilled carcass allowed to hang at temperature just off freezing for up to 6 weeks achieves similar gains in tenderness to meat hung for shorter periods at slightly higher temperature, 35 to 40 degree Fahrenheit from 2 to 10 days. Freezing the carcass prior to recommencing normal aging also increases the tenderness without affecting juiciness or flavor for lamb meat at least. Influence of age. Young animals are tender anyway because the protein breaking down enzyme system decreases as an animal gets older. So, paradoxically, aging the meat by leaving it to hang for some week works best with younger animals least likely to need it. In general, as animals age, the amount of connective tissue increases. More importantly, the degree of interconnectivity of the collagen increases with age, which results in the collagen becoming resistant to dissolution in cooking. Thus, meat from older animals can become more resistant to tenderization in cooking and require longer, slower cooking, such as braising, casseroling, or pot roasting, to deal with the greater amount and connectivity of the collagen. The tenderness variation from species to species is due primarily to the chronological age of the animal at the time of slaughter. Beef normally is processed at approximately 20 months of age, lamb at 8 months, and pork at 5 months of age, while as veal at approximately 2 months of age. The decrease in tenderness with increasing age is due to the changing nature of collagen, the connective tissue protein found in meat. Collagen becomes more complex and stronger with advancing age and thus is more resistant to tenderization from moist heat cooking. Pork and lamb from older animals normally are processed into sausage items, so toughness due to age usually is not a problem. Influence of marinating. Some plant substances have a tenderizing effect. The best known is papaya fruit, which contains a protein breaking down enzyme called papain. Kiwi fruit have similar proteolytic enzymes, though not as effective. Crude ginger rhizome extract at 0.5 to 1% levels in the marination of marginally acceptable lean beef improved meat tenderness by 20 to 30% in the absence of 2% salt and by 35 to 45% in the presence of 2% salt. By crude ginger rhizome extract, we can assume they mean ginger root juice. Marinating in fresh ginger clearly significantly tenderizes rather tough cuts of lean beef. Influence of vitamin D supplementation. Tests in USA have demonstrated that animals fed or injected with vitamin D for 7 days before slaughter have more tender meat. About 26% more tender strip loin than undosed control animals, and lesser improvements for top sirloin and inside round. It is suspected that the vitamin D greatly increases blood calcium levels, both absorption and retention, which in turn assist the naturally occurring enzymes which break down muscle fiber when meat is aged after death. Preliminary indications are that while tougher animals become tenderer, animals that already have tender meat are little affected. At this stage, the process is still largely experimental, with experiments continuing this northern hemisphere summer, particularly to sort out the best dose rate and timing, as at the moment most animals injected with large amounts of vitamin D stop feeding after about 5 days, an undesirable effect unless the animals are going to be slaughtered within around 5 days of treatment. calcium injection. Because high blood calcium levels improve the natural enzymatic aging of meat after death, experiments have been done over the last 10 years or so with giving cattle oral drenches of calcium before slaughter, infusing calcium into the carcass through veins and arteries, and injecting calcium directly into the primal beef cuts. All have increased the tenderness of the meat, with oral calcium a few hours before slaughter improving tenderness by about 1 kg shear force over untreated animals. Injections of calcium chloride post-slaughter have only increased tenderness in chilled beef after rigor mortis has set in. Influence of genetics. Australian trials have identified bulls whose progeny have not just more meat and more marbling but also tender meat. The same trial also showed that one bull produced very good amounts of meat in the progeny, but the meat was very tough. So there is variability within a breed. Again, in the USA, the Brahman breed is considered to lack meat tenderness. When investigated, it was found that different Brahman breeding bulls gave cows with different muscle tenderness, with the mean values by sire ranging from 5.3 to 6.8 kg in the shear test. In one examination of breed influences in USA, Piedmontese passed on very good tenderness traits when crossbred to Angus and Hereford. For example, where the same crosses with the Nellore breed as a sire were found to be relatively tough, double-muscled breeds have been shown to have meat as tender as standard European breeds, and for a number of cuts, it is tenderer. Tenderness is heritable. In sheep, there are breed differences in the pH of muscles. Copeworth meat has tested at pH 5.7 and purebred merinos at pH 6.16. Crossbreds tend to be intermediate as you would expect. At high and low levels, pH affects tenderness, with lowest pH and highest pH being most tender, but lowest pH having the best flesh texture. Again, there is a degree of heritability of tenderness. Overall, while there are breed differences in tenderness, the differences are not very large and relate mainly to a reduced calpain enzyme system responsible for postmortem aging in Boeus indicus. Recently, a variant of calpain 1 gene has been identified that codes for part of the calpain protease enzyme system. The gene variant is relatively widespread in beef herds, but exerts its influence most when the animal carries only the variant form. This specific gene, even when fully expressed, still only accounts for 20% of tenderness. It does open the possibility of deliberately breeding this gene into herds. But one scientist estimates only 30% of the tenderness of meat can be assessed to all forms of genetic influences. Aside from the calpain, gene variants, muscle fiber thickness can vary from 40 micrometer to 80 micrometer. Collagen solubility from 28% to 6%. Elastin fibrils vary from 0.6 micrometer to 4 micrometer, where the first number in each case is from tender meat and the second from the tough meat. The rest is environment, feed, nutritional status, handling, stress, post-kill treatment. Differences between sires within a breed are probably more important, particularly for BOS indicus, and this might relate in large part to which sires are dominant for the highly active form of the calpain-1 gene. But even the tenderest meat derived from progeny of the most select of sires can be ruined by stress before slaughter. It's immediately before and after slaughter that tender meat is ruined. And even in the best bred animals, the cheapest cuts will never be tender. Now we will tell you the different methods of meat tenderization. These are the basic methods for meat tenderization. In natural tenderization, tenderization is done naturally. Mechanical tenderizers are machines or devices made in different styles, hand crank, push, or electric. There are also attachments that fit on some electric meat grinders. All are designed to do one thing, tenderize meat by cutting muscle tissue. Chemical tenderization is the addition of meat tenderizing enzymes which affect the connective tissue. This method is used to both flavor and tenderize meat. Marinating is a technique to improve tenderness and add taste variety to the meat component of meals. The basic ingredients of a marinade include salt or soya sauce, acid like vinegar, lemon, Italian salad dressing or soya sauce, and enzymes such as papain, bromelain, ficin, or fresh ginger root. Freezing rate also plays a small role in tenderness. Natural method of meat tenderization. Most meat is normally required to age for a period of up to 3 weeks in order for it to be commercially acceptable for human consumption. Good quality meat can be aged longer if desired. During the aging process, the connective tissues of meat are broken down by the natural enzymes of meat, thereby improving the tenderness and edibility. Meat can be dry aged longer time with weight loss or wet aged shorter time with no weight loss. Meat is kept refrigerated during aging and the humidity is controlled. Several methods are employed to reduce the aging period and to increase the degree of tenderness. One of these is the regulated application of heat, light, or both of these to the meat, which speeds up the natural enzyme or bacterial action. Mechanical tenderizers are machines or devices made in different styles, hand crank, push, or electric. There are also attachments that fit on some electric meat grinders. All are designed to do one thing, tenderize meat by cutting muscle tissue. Mechanical tenderization is a method whereby fine incisions are made in the meat by closely spaced, specially designed knives which cut the connective tissue. The mechanical tenderization process takes less than 1 minute with a roller type tenderizer or a crank type hand operated tenderizer. Meat which has been treated in this manner is immediately tenderized without the use of chemicals or other artificial means or the need to wait for natural bacterial action to take place. The depth and the spacing of the knives and the number of times the meat is passed through the tenderizer permits the degree of tenderization to be determined, thus controlling the amount of tenderizing. Almost every grade of meat can be tenderized without danger of meat fabric deterioration or granulation. Meat which has been mechanically tenderized retains more of its natural appearance, shape, color, and weight. Grinding is a very popular means of increasing tenderness of meat, especially beef. The popularity of hamburger and ground beef is due in part to the fact that texture and tenderness is more uniform than tenderness of steaks and roasts. Cubing is another means of mechanically tenderizing meat. The small blades of a cuber simply sever connective tissue in boneless retail cuts so that the connective tissue is broken into smaller pieces. Blade or needle tenderization of cuts recently has increased in popularity. This method of tenderization is employed on wholesale cuts that are in turn processed in the normal manner into retail cuts. Needle or blade tenderization. Needle tenderization utilizes a set of needles or blades which pierce the meat, as can be seen in figure. Cutting through muscle fibers and connective tissue and improving tenderness. Needle tenderization can be performed on wholesale cuts such as whole ribeye rolls or shoulder clods or an individual steak and roasts. Needle tenderization used on wholesale cuts is referred to as needled or needling. Cubing, maceration, and pounding. Cubing and pounding are very effective methods of improving the tenderness of beef steaks. Cubing utilizes small blades on rollers and results in the surface of the steak being completely macerated, causing a complete change in the look and texture of the steak. Cubing is only useful for steaks because the type of equipment used for cubing can only process steaks. Cubing of beef is often done to very tough cuts such as inside round steak, but it's also used for knuckle steaks, chuck tender steaks, and others. Cubing is often done at retail as the disruption of the surface results in a diminished display life. Small meat shops may cube round steaks and then freeze them. Cubing is used when making products such as Swiss steak or chicken fried steak. Cubing is not appropriate for tender cuts such as ribeyes, tenderloins, and many value cuts. Pounding accomplishes the same result as cubing but is usually only done at home using a meat hammer. Chemical method. Chemical method is the addition of meat tenderizing enzymes which affect the connective tissue. This method is used to both flavor and tenderize meat. They are applied to meat by injection, rubbing, soaking, or vacuum. When soaking meat, always keep under refrigeration. A push-style tenderizer with round prongs will provide access holes, allowing these chemical tenderizers to quickly penetrate the meat, thus speeding up the tenderizing process. This is called forking. Often, the enzyme is included as part of a marinade, which include various spices and flavor enhancers. For this method, the marinade can be applied through the mechanical process called forking, allowing the enzyme to penetrate the meat cut. Then, by cooking immediately, a tenderized and highly palatable product is produced. Since these enzymes are deactivated by heat, they will continue to tenderize the meat until the meat is cooked. The heat will deactivate the enzyme. This is why meat tenderized using this method should be cooked and not stored. If stored and not cooked right away, a mushy, unpalatable texture will be present. Marinating. Marinating is a way consumers can improve tenderness and add taste variety to the meat component of meals. The basic ingredients of a marinade include salt or soy sauce, acid like vinegar, lemon, Italian salad dressing or soy sauce, and enzymes such as pepain, bromelain, piscine, or fresh ginger root. Some marinade recipes call for addition of an alcohol source, wine or brandy for flavor. The addition of several tablespoonfuls of olive oil will seal the surfaces from the air and thus will result in the meat staying fresher and brighter in color for a longer period of time. Freezing. Freezing rate plays a small role in tenderness. When meat is frozen very quickly, small ice crystals form. When meat is frozen slowly, large ice crystals are formed. While the formation of large crystals may serve to disrupt components of muscle fibers in meat and thereby increase tenderness very slightly, the large ice crystals result in an increased loss of juices upon thawing. This increase in loss of juices results in meat that is less juicy upon cooking and therefore usually is perceived as being less tender. Manual tenderizers are made in two styles, hammer and push. Both are designed to do one thing, that's tenderize meat by breaking or cutting muscle tissue of tough cuts of meat or punching holes in the meat to provide easier and quicker access for marinades and meat tenderizing enzymes used in the chemical method. Hammering the meat with a hammer type device breaks the meat's connective tissue and some meat fabric deterioration or granulation will occur. Push style units work like the mechanical units, except the cutting knives are pushed into meat when the user applies force to the handle. The push type that has blades will cut the connective tissue, thus tenderizing the meat. A push tile with round prongs will provide access holes for the chemical tenderizers, which in turn tenderize the meat. So, students, let us now summarize what we have done in this module. Paprika peppers are native to Central and South America, but are now cultivated in Hungary, Morocco, Mexico, Spain, Turkey, and the United States. There are four types: American, Spanish, Mexican, and Hungarian. All differ in pungency and sweetness. Paprika always refers to a ground product prepared of highly colored, mild, or sweet red fruits. The major quality factors are color and pungency. The best grades of paprika: special, capsaicin free, and delicatessen are used to make grade 1, while grade 2 fruits are used to make lower grades of paprika like fine sweet, semi sweet, etc. The color value of paprika color is not less than 300 and is in a range of 95% to 115% of the labeled value. The pungency of capsicum species depends on the concentration of capsaicinoids, particularly capsaicin, in pepper fruit. Usually sweet paprika, the most commonly grown pepper in Morocco and Spain, has very low capsaicinoid content. That's all about quality attributes of paprika. Thank you.
Dear students, in the present module, we have seen the important aspects of tenderization of meat, which has been explained by my co-author. Now, in the next module, we'll be knowing the storage aspects with respect to chilling and freezing of carcass as well as meat. Thank you.